Okay, cooking time again. Today, very special. Okay, anyway, because this is a Singapore fish head curry. So I show you the fish. This is the fish. Actually, I mix both. Okay, this is the fish grouper, the fish head grouper. Lapo-lapo ko sa Pilipinas. Is it? Yeah. Then the tail, and this is the ribs. Like sweet snapper like that. The meat. Okay, so, and this is some of the ingredient here. Okay, eggplant. You can see, right? The eggplant. Oh, this is the curry paste. You know, remember my first, the vegetable curry that I made? The paste, so this is the one. I keep some, so it's the same. This is the tamarind pulp. I will soak water with us later. So mix. So this is, we call it a Singapore fish head asam curry fish. Then tomato. And then lady's finger or okra. And then brinjal. And then the coconut milk. So now in here, I already heating up my wok here. Oh, wait. Yeah, it's like that. And then maybe you can see. Yeah, like that, you can see. Okay, it's already hot. Then what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna put the oil. Oil. A little bit. I don't want to make it wait till very hot because I don't want to splash all over this one. So put in the curry paste. This is I made a mix of lemongrass, onion, candle nuts, blue ginger, yellow ginger, shallots, garlic, and the belacan. So I will saute this one till it becomes curry paste. See? Oh, the aroma coming out all over the house. Yeah, it's a kind of strong smell, but it's nice. So I will just saute this one until all the color will change and then all the oil will come out. And then, yeah, we'll saute this like for 5 to 10 minutes.
A few moments later.
Okay, this is how it looks like now. After frying for 10 minutes, see it become dry and oily. Hold up. Yeah, so just like that, fry until all the curry paste dry and cook. See it become very red. Yeah, so now I'm going to add in the, because actually if it will dry like this, you need to add more oil, but I don't want to become too oily. So instead add oil, I will add the coconut now, the half of the coconut. That later I will add another half. See, slowly add the coconut milk. So, right, stop. Instead you're adding more oil, I will add coconut. So that at least not so oily your curry. See, this is how to cook fish head curry in Singapore. Singapore style. When you come to Singapore, it's very famous, the fish head curry. Oh, if you love spices. So this one, Singapore fish head curry. So we'll fry this until all the oil will come out. So you can see the difference now. Yeah, looks good now. So just like this, fry till it become very red. And see, this oil all over there. So this is the time to add in your water. So remember I showed you just now the tamarind pulp, I will soak with water, yeah, just to make, I need the juice, so I will squeeze this one, we'll wash my hands for that. Then later I will add more water, yes, just like this guys. but it's not hot. It's just purely plain, clear water soup. So this one is more spicy. So now I'm gonna add the water. So after this, I will add the water till, huh? Okay guys, see, I already poured the water, right? I let it boil, so later I will add in the fish here. For now, I will going to season it. I will season it with the fish sauce. This brand of fish sauce from Thailand is very nice. But of course not too much, because fish sauce is got a pungent smell. You know, the smell is very strong. Got it in too much. So I put the fish sauce and I have this chicken stock. The concentrated chicken stock. I used to make my chicken stock, but today I don't have. So use this one. So fish sauce and the chicken stock for seasoning. So I will let it boil. Once it boils, I will add in the fish and the vegetables.
1 eternity later.
Okay. Now it's boiling nicely now. So time to add in your fish. This is the red grouper, you know, snapper or what you call this. So it inside in. So this one will take more nicer, takes there because of the fish. And this is the tail. Okay. You see there's a part, there's a head because we love head. And the tail and the kids. Head. And this is the flesh, the meat, the flesh. See, this is where you see the gravy, just the consistency is just right, not too thick and not too watery. Yeah, that's all done. This curry for today.